General John Campbell. I'm the 34th Vice Chief of Staff of the Army. I'm on a health of the force trip. What I've done here for yesterday, today, and tomorrow, I've tried to pick out a post camper station that had mostly civilians. That was Picatinny Arsenal in New Jersey. I was there yesterday. Picked two places that are force comm, so that's Fort Drum, and I'll go to Fort Campbell this afternoon. And then I really wanted to get out of trait dot post. That's a really a training post. That's Fort Jackson. I'll head there tomorrow. And really the focus for me is to take a look at the Ready and Resilient campaign. And the Army put out this order in the February-March time frame to take a look at Ready and Resilience. And I'm really coming to post campus stations to see how we're implementing that and decisions and policies and resources, what we can do at the headquarters department of the Army level to really help facilitate Ready and Resilience. Because we do believe with all the stresses out there, we got to take our soldiers from the time they come into the Army, build resiliency with them all the way to the time that they get out, not only in our soldiers, but our families and our great civilians. So that's really been my focus. Fort Drum here has some very great programs. General Townsend briefed me on several yesterday. I've had some leader forums. I've had some soldier engagements. Everywhere I go, I'm very impressed with the leadership of Fort Drum and what the soldiers are doing, and then the great support of the civilians here at Fort Drum. Fort Drum continues to be one of those posts that stays engaged with the war fight in Afghanistan. I tell people we can never ever forget what's going on in Afghanistan. The people here know better than anybody else the sacrifices of the families and our soldiers. If you're back in Washington, where I'm at all the time, sometimes you forget about that. In the month of June, we had 235 soldiers wounded. In the month of July, we had about 200 wounded, several killed in both those months. So this continues to be very personal to Fort Drum, and I want to make sure we continue to do things to help out Fort Drum and those soldiers and families deployed. So that's what I'm doing, very quick trip, but appreciate the opportunity to engage in any of the questions you may have here.
Talk is whether or not furloughs will be coming, will be shortened.
Yep.
If that will be cut from the 11 weeks that's at now. Is there any word you have for
I haven't seen any decision. I've been in different meetings where it's been talked about with the Secretary of Defense, Secretary of the Army, the Chief of Staff. And remember, this is a DOD policy. It'll be made as a DOD decision that all the services will be the same. Furlough is sort of like sequestration. Nobody wanted it to go that way. And really, all the services were a little bit different, but for the Army, we had a bill in 13. We continue to have a bill in 13 to fund the war fight. It was about an $8.3 billion bill. We couldn't pay that till we had some things happen. So decision was made to go to furlough. It started about 22, went to 11 days. I think we've had 3 days go by so far. We understand the impact that has on the families and the people that are furloughed. And the department is really working very hard to make sure that we can hopefully buy back some of those. I don't know the days. I've heard anywhere between 3 and 6. But again, the Secretary of Defense will make that decision. What's changed and why can we do it now? Because we couldn't do it a month or two ago. Well, several things. We're still waiting on a reprogramming action from Congress, which is about $5 billion. If that happens, that'll help alleviate some of that bill. Fuel price has changed in Afghanistan. The number of things we have to bring back has been adjusted. So we worked very hard with TRANSCOM and with the folks in theater to reduce that bill by about $1.5 billion. Some other reprogramming that we've been able to enact in the Army has helped us. So we believe now that hopefully we can buy back, and we look at that as buy back readiness, because our great civilians provide to that readiness. And if you look at it in that terms, it's absolutely the right thing to do. So we're going to continue to work very hard with the department to see if we can buy back some of those furloughs. We understand the impact, and we do appreciate the value of our great civilians and thank them for their dedication and their continued patience to stay with us at that. You know, as I talk to the civilians up here, they're more worried about completing the mission than they are about the furlough piece. So, I mean, that shows you the kind of people and the caliber that you have up here at Fort Drum.
General, the Army downsizing that was announced not long ago, are all the
you guys don't want to get into Ready and Resilient here, do you? Go ahead, I'm sorry.
We're going to circle back.
All right.
All the details, have they been worked out in timetable, everything about how that's going to affect the folks here?
Well, you know, the Army announced probably on the 25th of June, somewhere around there, about reducing the number of brigades. And that was to take the Army from a high, the active side, from 570 to 490,000. And that includes force structure. And so those brigades were identified. One of those was here up at Fort Drum. The chief brought that out in a press conference, but he also talked about that's pre-sequestration. That's all based on the Budget Control Act of 2011. If we continue at full sequestration, and the Secretary of Defense went out yesterday and talked about potential, those numbers. And so I'm pretty sure that we're going to go below 490 on the active. We're also going to have to take some cuts in the other compos, being our National Guard and the United States Army Reserve. The Army's looking at that, and we're studying that right now. No decisions have been made on how low we will go, but the the talk there that was out there by the secretary shows is well below the 490. And, you know, these will be the lowest levels of Army since pre-1940. So your Army's going to get smaller. The challenge that we have, and what Secretary McHugh and General Odierno are committed to doing, is as we continue to downsize, that we don't become a hollow force. So we have to balance our end strength, we have to balance our modernization, and we have to balance readiness. And so we'll continue to work that very hard. So no decisions, but again, the balance for the chief is to make sure we keep those three levers kind of in balance. But you know, it depends on sequestration where Congress goes. My read right now is there's no forcing mechanism to bring them together to keep us from going to sequestration. That's very sad, and we're never supposed to go there. So hopefully Congress will get together and they'll take a hard look at this piece.
Sir, the second, here at Fort Drummond, the 1st and 2nd Brigade Cav are over in Afghanistan right now. What have you heard about what their mission so far and what they've done and the progress they've made?
Yeah, great question. And again, I can never forget what they're doing over there, and we've got to continue to tell the American people that we've got people in harm's way, and Fort Drummond has been the brunt of that for many years. I was in Afghanistan probably about a month and a half ago and had an opportunity to sit down with the leadership to visit both RC East and RC South to see some of the 10th Mountain Division soldiers. And what I got from them is they're still committed to the mission. They understand how important it is. They're getting at this security assistance piece of it. They continue to get the Afghans out in front. I feel very confident of what they're doing and how they continue to enable the Afghan soldiers. The issues they're having are the same issues we have with other armies, our army, the things that are very hard to do, so sustainment, logistics, medevac, joint fires, those are going to be hard for the Afghan soldiers as we move forward. That's something we've got to continue to stay after. But the assistance piece and kind of putting them in charge, the number of casualties that the Afghans are starting to take is continues to rise. They're in the fight, and you know they continue to get better each day because of the climb to glory soldiers that they're around. The issues they're having is governance, you know, and that's been the same thing for the last several years, and continue to work the governance piece of it. But I feel very good about what the soldiers continue to do over there.
For the readiness campaign, what kind of things are you seeing there positives for Fort Drum as far as what they're doing, or some things that they still need to work on?
Yeah, the Ready and Resilience campaign is not a new program. What we're really taking a look at is all these other programs that are out in the Army, kind of putting it under the umbrella of Ready and Resilience. So, as I talk to soldiers, they may not understand it as Ready and Resilience, but they understand the term resilience. I think they understand where we're trying to go with this. Here at Fort Drum, it's Mountain Tough. And under that campaign plan, the commanding general is really focusing all those pieces of all the different programs. The issue we're going to have is as we move forward, we're not going to be able to afford all of those programs. So we have to take the best programs we have, the ones that make the difference to the soldiers up here at Fort Drum. And what may be best of practice at Fort Drum may not work at another post camp or station. So we can't have a cookie cutter approach to it. We've got to really look hard to make sure we're providing the resources for what counts here at Fort Drum. But we're not going to have the same amount of resources we've had the last 10 years. So we have to make some very, very tough choices. And we depend upon the leadership here to help us determine what those are. I feel very good about sponsorship and what sponsorship does here at Fort Drum. They lead the way on probably the best program in the Army on sponsorship and taking a new soldier or a soldier that's coming from another post and kind of inculcating them with the ways of living here in the North Country in Fort Drum. So I feel very positive about that. The physical fitness. In some of the areas I looked at yesterday and what Fort Drum is doing is very innovative on the physical fitness side, different than I've seen at other post camps or stations, so great kudos to the leadership here for that. So I think Fort Drum had already started working this piece before the Army put out this Ready Resilient campaign. They'll continue to work that very hard, and I'm very proud of what they have already going on here.
We have time for one more question.
Okay.
General, could the resiliency campaign tie into recent report in the Army Times that detailed a spike in the child abuse in the Army and seemed to correlate that to returning soldiers from Afghanistan?
Yeah, absolutely, you can. Yeah. Resiliency is about having soldiers, family members, civilians deal with those pressures, those friction points, those stressors. And, you know, I read the Army Times report as well. I talked to Richard, the editor there, several months ago when they were looking at doing the story. And that absolutely falls under the rubric of Ready and Resilience. And as they brought that out, I think the numbers that they showed there, the Army has a much lower incident rate than civilian society. It's like 4.5 to 100 to 27.5 to 100, somewhere around there. So it's really out of proportion to civilian. But again, if you're in the Army, you know, one case is bad. So you can't try to go defend that. What you want to do is get after that problem and really work at. And I think the resilience piece of this and educating family members and soldiers about this problem and then providing them the resources and the tools to be able to get at it is definitely under the rubric of ready and resilient. So, you know, the good thing about the Army is we're a learning organization. We find an issue if we had not been tracking, then we get right after that and we work it very hard, whether it's the child piece here, whether it's suicide, whether it's drugs. You know, the Army will continue to work that very hard. So, hey, just a real shout out to all the Fort Drum community and the North Country out here. And we can never forget the sacrifices that this post and this this area of the country has taken for our country. They continue to be in harm's way. An opportunity to go to Bethesda, Walter Reed here last week and visit many of our wounded warriors. Many Fort Drum soldiers continue to be down there. And when you go to a place like that and feel the resiliency that they have and the passion and the energy, it's pretty incredible. And so we can never forget their sacrifice. And again, our Gold Star families out there that pay the ultimate sacrifice. So proud to be up here, and I look forward to some other discussions here at Fort Drum. Thanks very much. Climb to glory.